Hey guys, this is Jam of JamOnline.ph and today we're gonna unbox and take a closer look at the Oppo Reno smartphone. So this is the latest mid-range smartphone from Oppo. And yes, it does come in two variants, the 10X with a better specifications and this one. So this one comes with a Snapdragon 710 processor. We also got your 6.4 inch Super AMOLED Full HD Plus display, 6 gigs of RAM, 256 gigs of internal storage. There's a dual lens camera at the back, 48 megapixel plus 5 megapixel, and then there's the 16 megapixel front camera. There's an in-display fingerprint scanner, 3765 milliamp hours of battery, ColorOS 6 based on Android 9 Pie, and the one that we got comes in ocean green. So what's unique about this smartphone is we got here a shark fin style pop-up camera, which is unique pop-up camera that we've seen on a smartphone. So yes, what are we waiting for? So let's unbox and let's take a closer look at the Oppo Reno smartphone. Alright, so you're looking at the box of the Oppo Reno. So this smartphone comes with a dual lens compared to the Oppo Reno 10X that has a triple lens camera. This one only packs a Snapdragon 710 processor. I know the box looks odd to you guys. I mean, it's very tall. So what are we waiting for? So let's unbox this smartphone. Alright, so time to remove the box. So this one comes with the security information and the manual. Of course, we got here the Oppo Reno smartphone along with the main specifications and features of the Reno. We also got here the charger, and it comes with an output of 5 volts, 4 amperes, that's a total of 20 watts. I believe this is a VOOC fast charger. We also got here a plastic case. Yes, it's a little bit soft, and we also got here, I believe this is a plastic. Yes, just a cover for that one. And yeah, just a basic case for the Oppo Reno. Of course, we got here the USB-C to USB-A cable. And this one comes with a VOOC logo. So it means that you need to use this one to take advantage of the VOOC fast charging of the Oppo Reno smartphone. And also the earphones with the green color inside, along with the 3.5 audio jack. Yes, it's not Type-C, thankfully. So you're looking at the Oppo Reno smartphone, and as you can see here, we got a really stylish design. And according to Oppo, one of its USPs is that the smartphone does have a beautiful and sexy design, and I can agree with that one, as we got here a glass back, and it's kind of like a frosted glass, similar to the R17 Pro's back. And then we also got here the horizontal design. We got here the Oppo design by Oppo, and then we also got here a small bump that protects the camera, and also the camera over here. What I like about it is that we do not have a protruding camera. That's why we have a bump over here to protect the glass of the camera of the smartphone. So, you know, you could avoid the scratches on the glass of the camera. Anyway, the glass back does feel premium to me, similar to the R17 Pro. We also got here a nice curves at the back, which adds to the ergonomic and grip of the smartphone. I do like the grip of this one, but I still suggest that you use the included case on the Oppo Reno, as this one is kind of slippery to me because of the glass back. So below we got here the USB-C port and also the headphone port, so you could still use your old earphones and also other speakers that aren't wireless. We also got here the speaker grill. On the right side, we got here the power button that comes with a green accent, and also the volume rocker on the other side. So at the top, we got here the notch. Oh, sorry, this is the shark fin like pop-up camera that I'm gonna show that to you later. And yes, this is the R17 Pro. I'm really confused, the R17 Pro in this one. So this is the Oppo Reno smartphone. This is their current premium mid-range smartphone, and I like the design of this one. We also got here a full screen display. As you can see, there's no notch in here thanks to the pop-up camera. We do have a tiny notch below, and I like the screen to body ratio of this smartphone. We also got here a flat display. There's no curved display like the Find X, and it's almost similar to the other Oppo smartphones with no notch, but this one has a more superior display, as this one packs a better colors and better viewing angles. So we're still running on ColorOS 6. That is not surprising. And yes, it's running on Android 9 Pi, and again we got the 6 gigs variant with Snapdragon 710 and 256 gig storage. And yes, this one is pretty snappy. As you can see here, the transitions are everything, and they're really easy to use. It's snappy and it's really fast. So let's talk about the software of the smartphone. So again, we do have Color OS 6 inside. I like the color of this one, matches my cutting board. And yeah, we got here the basic applications. We got here the Theme Store, the Oppo App Store. We also got here some tools that you won't probably use. And but I actually use the Keep Notes, but I'm not using the clone phone. But this one is really useful when you're transferring from one phone to another. Then we also got here the File Manager, Photos, Music, Phone Manager that lets you optimize everything about the smartphone. I mean, the storage, you can clean it up. You got privacy permissions, you got virus scan, but I doubt that you will have virus on this smartphone. Of course, payment protection and some routine tests to, you know, optimize the performance of the smartphone. We also got here this music party that lets you use other smartphones to have your own house party, as long as they have that app. Most of the smartphones that has that one. We also got here the game space, which lets you boost the gaming performance of the smartphone. So this one, this feature or this application can be seen on other Oppo smartphones too. We also got here O-roaming. This one is pretty useful, especially that if you love traveling outside the country, but I don't use that one. We also got here the hat applications. These are the bloatwares, but I believe you could uninstall that one. This one came from the Oppo App Store, so you don't have to worry about that one. We also got here the hot games. Yes, basically that's the Oppo App Store. We got here Facebook, the Google News, Lazada, Opera, and Web Novel. So basically this one comes with a pretty fast, pretty smooth navigation. It's user friendly. However, there are some bloatwares that you might want to uninstall first before using the Oppo Reno smartphone. So you already know the software of the smartphone. You already know the design and what I think about the Oppo Reno. But how about the camera? Actually, guys, I've tried the camera of the Oppo Reno. It's a big upgrade compared to its F series brothers. And I'm gonna show you first the front-facing camera. There we go. That's the like shark fin like front facing camera of the smartphone, and it's actually performing pretty well. And the UI is kind of same. So if you've used an Oppo smartphone before, you won't be confused with this one. So basically we got here the night mode, panorama mode, expert mode, time lapse, slow mo, video. So this one can record up to 4K. That's pretty good to me. I mean, this one is a mid-range smartphone. I believe this one is priced at $26,990. Then we got here the photo mode, portrait mode. So basically this one is similar to the portrait mode to like other smartphones and other Oppo phones. But of course, the performance of this one, we'll have to review this one yet. And it will be posted on jamonline.ph. So yes, you know the camera features of the smartphone, but how does it perform? Well, I took some liberty to take some shots using the Oppo Reno smartphone. As you can see here, we got here really nice colors on the pencil, and the saturation of this one is quite okay. It's not oversaturated. It's almost on point. And the display of this one helps in displaying the beauty of the photos. So this one's another shot, although it's not a perfect one, but the colors of this one is kind of okay. And the details, well, they are pretty detailed. And I cannot say that this one is almost on par or on par with most flagship smartphones, but this one is quite as good as most premium mid-range smartphones or even other flagship smartphones. So yeah, thumbs up to Oppo for this one. So as you can see here, although it's a little bit not overblown, but a little high highlights over here, then yeah, basically it's a good one. So this one is a selfie, so I've used the selfie camera of the smartphone. So this one is pretty detailed. I didn't use AI on this one. I prefer using the normal mode without AI. You can see here that the details are quite fine. You could actually catch my eyebrows pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty good. And then we also got here really nice colors, really nice skin tone. I like the selfie camera of this one. The selfie camera of this one is quite okay. It's actually great. So yes, another selfie. And again, you can see the details on this one. The skin tones are good. The lighting is good. The contrast is good. Everything is almost perfect on this one. But again, it's not the best selfie camera smartphone, but the selfie on this smartphone is really great compared to other mid-range smartphones. So yeah, I guess that's it for our unboxing hands-on of the Oppo Reno smartphone. So if you like this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and don't forget to check out my social media channels. So yeah, so if you like this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, well, now's the time to subscribe. And of course, to our fans who are watching at Facebook, be sure to like this page and also to see first this page. So yeah, see you guys again on my next video.